Imam Salamullahi Alayhi spent his time educating, teaching, but through his action. And if you read Sahifa Sajjadiyya, brothers and sisters, you'll find several du'as where the Imam is praying for the Ummah. Imam teaches to pray for our parents, for our children, for our neighbors, for those who are in need, for those who are in difficulties. That's always in Sahifa Sajjadiyya to remember the mu'mineen. He lived this life 33 years after Karbala, but in difficulty, in lots of pain. When he was fed the poison, salamullahi alayhi, by al-Walid ibn Abd al-Malik ibn Marwan, and he felt the pain of the poison, he called upon his son, al-Imam al-Baqir, salamullahi alayhi, and he said, son, Walid has done it. I've been fed the poison, and I can see my days are numbered now. So he starts giving some admonishments to his son, al-Baqir, salamullahi alayhi. He tells him, son, I will tell you what my father told me as the final word of admonishment, the final words of my father to me before he left this dunya. He came to me, and listen to this hadith, brothers and sisters. Now think about it. Imam al-Hussein is going to get martyred, and these are the last words he's teaching his son, Imam al-Sajjad, alayhi salam. The last word. What did he tell him? He said, son, be aware. Never oppress or do injustice against someone who has none other than Allah against you. Don't you think that you're almighty and powerful? There are people in this dunya who are very weak. They cannot really answer. They cannot really respond to you. You can do whatever you want to them. This could be an employee at work. It could be a child. It could be a spouse. It could be anyone in the society. Someone who has no value. Some homeless person on the street. These people who feel weak, vulnerable, don't you ever do injustice against them. They have none other than Allah against you. Imam al-Hussein's last words to Imam al-Sajjad were these words. Be aware, be careful, not to do injustice against someone who has none other than Allah against you. And I tell you the same words, my son. These are the words I leave you with as well before leaving this dunya. And then he tells him, among what he told him, son, the camel that I have, this camel, I did Hajj with it 20 times. 20 years I've done Hajj with this camel. Because of its services to me, when it dies, I request you to bury this camel. Bury it. Look at the respect, the care. People talk today of animal rights. Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam says, then the pain came too much upon my father on his final day. He said the shahada. And he said, Bismillah wa billah wa ala millati jaddi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih. Today I'm going to meet my father Abi Abdullah al-Hussein. Maybe the Imam is saying, after all these 33 years that I've lived in pain, in difficulty, finally I'm going to be at relief. I'm going to be relieved from this difficulty of dunya. And the Imam, salamullahi alayhi, leaves this dunya. Imam al-Baqir, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, then takes care of his father, Imam al-Sajjad. And he says, after burying my father, Imam al-Sajjad, that camel that he told me about would come out of the house and go and sit on the grave of Imam al-Sajjad, salamullahi alayhi. I would ask it to come back. It wouldn't. The whole day until in the evening, then the camel comes back with me to the house. The second day it went and did the exact same thing. The third day, the camel sat on the qabr of the Imam. Imam Al-Baqir says, when I came to it by the end of the day, I saw that it had left this dunya. So I followed the wasiyah of my father and I buried that camel as my father had wished. A camel understands the greatness of Imam Sajjad alayhi salam. But today when you go to his qabr, you find it in darkness. And people are not allowed to go there. Then after finishing the ghusl of his father, Imam Al-Baqir alayhi salam was seen crying out loudly. They asked him, Ya ibn Rasulillah, what is the matter? He saw, when I was washing the body of my father, Imam Sajjad alayhi salam, I saw the marks of the chains of Karbala on his neck, on his hands, and on his feet. I remembered the difficulty my father experienced in Karbala after all these decades, all these years, and the marks of the pain of the chains are still on his body. I started thinking, how much pain did he experience when he had those chains on him? Al-Minhal ibn Sa'ad says, I saw Imam Sajjad alayhi salam in Sham. I arrived in Sham and I saw the people of Sham celebrating. I told them, is there a Eid in Sham that we are unaware of? People told me, yes, there were a group of outlaws who have come against the Khalifa Yazid, and Allah made him victorious and he captured them and he killed some of them. And today the prisoners are arriving. So he said, I kept walking, everyone is celebrating, the drums are beating, people are dancing. But then I came across a group of people who were hiding in a corner crying. I asked them, how come everyone is cheering but you are crying? What is the matter? They said, nothing is wrong, everything is okay, we're just having our own problems. He said, no, tell me the truth. I am Sahel ibn Sa'd. I'm a man who met Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi and heard his hadith. They said, if that is the case, ya Sahel, it is a strange thing that the skies haven't yet collapsed on the earth. Haven't you heard the news? No, what is the news? Hussein is killed in Karbala, ya Sahl. His family is brought as prisoners, and that's why these people are rejoicing and celebrating. He said, from which gate are they coming? They said, from a gate known as the gate of the clocks, Abab al-Sa'at. He said, I went there from a distance. I saw the family coming, and I saw Imam Sajjad alayhi salam wearing a red shirt. I was surprised. I have never seen Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wearing red. Why is the Imam wearing red? I approached the Imam. As I came closer to him, I realized he was not wearing a red shirt, but rather the shirt had been painted red from the blood of the Imam salamullahi alayhi, gushing from his neck, from his arms, from his feet. I told him, assalamu alayka ya ibn Rasulillah. He looked at me and said, who are you? Everyone around here is throwing stones at us. They're making us hear bad words, but you recognize us. Who are you? He said, I am Sahel ibn Sa'ad ibn Rasulullah. I'm a man who met your grandfather Rasulullah. I hear this hadith. Is there anything I can do for you? He said, Ya Sahel, do you have any cloth on you? He said, yes, I do. What do you want with it? He said, I want to keep it under this chain because it is really bothering my neck. He says, I gave him a piece of cloth. What else do you want, Ya ibn Rasulullah? Do you have money on you? He said, yes, I do. He said, then give it to the people who are carrying the heads of my father so that the people can be busy looking at them instead of looking at the faces of my Amma Zaynab and my aunts and sisters. He says, I went and gave them the money. But then I saw the family entering into Shaykh. السلام. And Imam Sajjad alayhi salam is with them as the people of Sham are rejoicing and celebrating. They're beating the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi with stones and pebbles. These memories were kept in the mind of Imam Sajjad for decades. Every day he would remember them. Abu Hamza Thumali says, I came to visit the Imam one day, salamullahi alayh. I saw him crying out loudly in pain. I told him, Yabna Rasulillah, Allah has honored you, Ahlul Bayt, with martyrdom. Why do you cry so much for Abi Abdullah al Hussein? He said, may Allah bless you, Ya Abu Hamza. But every time I look at my sisters, I look at the women of Bani Hashim, I remember them running on the day of Ashura from one tent to another tent as the tents are gone up in flames. And the daughters are crying, Aywa Husayna, Aywa Mataya. And the women are calling, Aywa Abbasa. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un wa say'alamu alladhina zalamu ayyamun qalabin yanqalibun wal aqibatu lil muttaqin.